Binary star systems are systems in which two stars are essentially orbiting their center of mass. These systems can have circular or elliptical orbits and are often unequal in size, causing the orbit around their center of mass to be skewed towards the larger star.
In our experiment, we want to create an artificial binary star system that uses magnets of equal strength and mass that rotate in a circular orbit around their center of mass. We would like to use magnetic strength instead of gravity because both forces follow inverse square laws.
Meaning that for every unit of distance increased between the two objects, the force on the objects will decrease in line with the square.
Our hypothesis is that the two magnets will rotate around their center of mass until they reach a point at which the air resistance slows down the magnets enough, the velocity is no longer strong enough to overcome the centripetal force, and the two magnets will snap together.
Using a combination of angular and linear physics concepts, we were able to determine an equation for the angular speed necessary for a given magnet strength, radius, and mass.
And now, a 3D demonstration.
We're magnets.
This is our velocity vector.
This is our acceleration vector.
In our experiment, we'll use a rotating rod to bring the magnets up to our calculated angular speed. Once that speed is achieved, the rod will retract and the magnets should continue to go on their own. We then anticipate that the magnets will slow down and come circling in towards each other.
Though to some, this may look like the world's most expensive desk toy, we think that it would give new insights into the workings of binary star systems. Also, if it was done several times with magnets of varying masses, the effect would be similar to that of a lumped binary star system.
This experiment would provide a stunning example of how linear concepts such as momentum, acceleration, and velocity can be easily translated into rotational equivalents.
Plus, it'd be really cool